In the previous video, I described how the researchers who sequenced the genome of Haemophilus influenzae constructed a genomic DNA library for the organism. The genomic library is the collection of plasmids, each of which contains a different insert representing 1,600 to 2,000 base pairs of the genome. In this video, I'll explain how they generated contigs representing larger sections of the genome. First, they obtained sequence information from each of the inserts in the library. The sequence of the vector, shown in black here, is known, so they could design sequencing primers complementary to the known sequence and use those primers to obtain sequence information from the inserts, shown in blue. Remember that the inserts are 1,600 to 2,000 base pairs long, while at the time they could obtain up to about 500 base pairs of sequence from one Sanger sequencing run. So they would not sequence the entire insert, just the first 500 base pairs or so. For some plasmids, they sequenced both ends of the insert. They ended up with over 24,300 reads, representing 11.6 million base pairs. This is over 6 times the length of the genome that they're trying to sequence. Because the fragments are randomly located on the genome, you need lots of reads to try to see as much of the genome as possible. The next step is to have the computer look for overlapping sequences among the 24,300 reads obtained from the plasmids. That's illustrated in this diagram, where each yellow rectangle represents a different sequencing read. These reads will end in random places because random fragments were obtained by sonication when making the genomic DNA library. So, some reads will span or go across the gap or break between other reads. The goal is to put the different fragments in order and reconstruct the original genome sequence. That's illustrated a bit differently here. Overlapping reads are analyzed to reconstruct longer sections of contiguous or connected genome sequence. But sometimes you'll have an end of a read that doesn't overlap with any other read in the collection. This will define the end of that contiguous sequence. Each reconstructed section of contiguous genomic sequence is called a contig. Note that a contig is not a physical object. It's a sequence of bases that represents a section of the genomic DNA sequence, and it is constructed by the computer. During this process, the computer was able to assemble the 24,300 individual reads into 140 contigs, representing 140 non-overlapping sections of the organism's genome. The researchers now had two problems. First, they had no sequence information for the regions of the genome in between the contigs. And second, they did not know what order the contigs should be arranged in. I've tried to illustrate the problem on this slide using 4 contigs instead of 140 for simplicity. If you already know the sequence of the genome, you'd be able to match up each contig to the appropriate place on the genome. But if the genome has never been sequenced before, you don't know where each contig should go. For example, contig 1 could go next to contig 4, not opposite to it, as I've shown here. You know that each contig represents part of the genome, but you don't know the order they should go in, and you don't know the size of the gap that's in between each contig. To figure out how the contigs fit together, the researchers needed to fill the gaps in between them. I'll describe how they did that in the next video.